There you go. Has the IPL handled the Stark Pollard incident in an appropriate manner? For people who aren't up to speed with this thing, we just got an update around an hour back. Mitchell Stark has copped a 50% match fee fine. Kyron Pollard has copped a 75% match fee fine. And Stark, of course, pleaded guilty to conduct contrary to the spirit of the game. Pollard pleaded guilty to throwing his bat at or near a player. Don't see how he could have wriggled out of that one. First thoughts, we spoke about this yesterday, Shishir, and you said that they probably should have been banned for a couple of games.
For a couple of games, you know, the answer is straight away no. They should have been banned at least two games for two reasons. One is you come out of the realm of, you know, franchisee appeasement and cricket takes priority. The decorum of the game takes priority. And that's when administrators gave out a clear signal to franchisees that, you know, the game, the discipline, the spirit is more important than the bucks you pay for a franchise or, you know, dominating a league. That is one. Two is you're sending out a serious message to people like Mark sitting in England and watching the game that this is not about, you know, appeasement of franchises. This is about the game. And this is where I think players and administration, especially the disciplinary committee, should have come on very hard. Despite, okay, you're banned for two games. It's okay. This is what you pay for. This is money. Money is not an issue here because, you know, when you're paying mega dollars for to buy a franchisee, it doesn't matter. You know, maybe the franchise will foot the bill. But is it going to sort your issue and create that credibility that is so important with what's happened around the IPL in the past? You want to send out a strong message. I think they've missed a trick here.
And I would just interject to say that, you know, this is what, you know, we can criticize Lalit Modi for a lot of things he did or didn't do. But when the same thing happened, you know, between Harbhajan and Srisant, Harbhajan was banned for, 10 games, 11 games.
For the entire season.
For the rest of the season. Yeah. And that was a big franchise. That was, again, Mumbai Indians. It was a big player. But he took that call. And, yeah, maybe he was grandstanding a bit. But he took that call. He took that decision. And we haven't seen a repeat of that since.
Yeah, Andy Pycroft was the match referee who handed out the fines. We don't know who else was there in the meeting. And both Pollard and Stark are fairly important players for those two franchises. Mark, looking at the IPL from where you are, how does this come across to you?
It doesn't reflect well on the game, but I wouldn't say that it was, you know, a finger pointing at the IPL because of that, because incidents like this happen in international cricket wherever it's being played under whatever banner. I totally agree. I don't agree with financial penalties. I think financial penalties are absolutely hopeless. They don't serve any purpose whatsoever. You know, you get things like captains being fined or teams being fined parts of match fees for poor overrates, etc., etc. If you're gonna make a big difference to things like overrates and if they really matter, then you have to give a penalty that affects the game that's going on while it's going on, either run penalties or whatever it might be, in order that it actually makes a difference to what's happening in front of you. When it comes to something like this, a ban is the only real way of saying this is behavior that we will not tolerate.
And to butt in just one more time, the ironic thing is we don't know how much Kyron Pollard has been fined because he was retained. We don't know what his match fee is. We don't know what his season fee is. So, you know, there's something very nebulous and, you know, we have no idea over there.
Everything the IPL happens behind closed doors, and this is just one of the other things. They make this whole talk about spirit of cricket. You know, there's this whole thing at the start of the tournament with all the captains signing the spirit of cricket pledge or whatever that is. There's a fair play award in place. However, that award gets that's decided at the end of the season. But are all of these things as eyewashes, Joy? How does it come across?
Mark and Shishir would know better, but I think, you know, okay, when you're out there, perhaps in the heat of the moment, you will do things and that will happen. And you can't sort of legislate, you have to have rules in place, but then you have to enforce those rules and you have to make sure that, you know, that there's a message that goes out. Yeah, maybe in the heat of the moment, Stark threw the ball, maybe in the heat of the moment, this Pollard threw his bat. All that happens, but you have to then act against that. So you send a message out of things do happen. It happens in football and in all sort of sport, in all sport like this. But then you have to send a message out that it's not going to be tolerated. And as Mark was saying, that financial fines are probably not the way, they don't hurt enough. You have to dock points or
And if I might add, fines don't hurt enough if you're not paying them.
Yeah.
So it just nullifies the whole effect of imposing a fine on a player, because we'll never know who's going to bear that, who's going to pay that bill or pick up that bill. Important is it should hurt the game, and once it hurts a player and his captain for him not playing because of what he's done in the past, that'll have a telling effect on the precedent that is set for the IPL in future. And players will be made to watch out by the franchise saying that, look, you lost us a game because you weren't available.
Shishir, you've been with a couple of franchises before. Do you have any indication, any idea about whether the franchise officials would have had a say or would have at least been able to influence the decision on what the fines were?
I wasn't there when Harbhajan and Srichand had that lover spat, but I can tell you one thing, that it's obvious, franchises are stakeholders in a Premier League like this. They've all contributed to make it where it is just now. So they will have a say in most matters. There will be pressures because, a loss of a key player is so critical to a team's performance. So I'm not prepared to believe that any franchisee won't have a say or a message won't go out to the disciplinary committee that, look, just take it easy on the player. This is where I think administrators will have to be above franchises and say, look, cricket comes first, decorum of the game comes first, everything else is secondary. And that's where they can build credibility of the IPL in future.
Can I ask you guys, it strikes me that you talk about the punishment that was meted out to Harbhajan and Srisath, both Indian players. Do you think the fact that both of these guys are overseas players has had something to do with the fact that the punishment was so lenient?
Not at all. I think it's marked more the fact that there are two very high-profile franchises. I don't think it has anything to do with Indian or foreigners, because every team has enough replacements, So they won't be affected in terms of numbers. Yes, in terms of quality players, yes, they will be affected. But it has more to do with the fact that a lot of franchises, I'm sure if it was an understated team, the fines would have been different. That's my personal view. I may be wrong, but this is the way I look at the IPL, that high-profile teams can put pressure on the disciplinary committee, saying that...
Wasn't Harbhajan playing for Mumbai Indians when he got there?
Yes, he was. But, what he did was caught on television, and what we saw yesterday was also caught on television. So I'm not very sure that there won't have been any pressure. I'm sure there was some kind of subtle pressure to say, look, just take it easy. We'll say sorry and let it go. But, You can't get into the confession box after doing what you did.
Well, there was another difference between that first season and what happened yesterday, of course. As Joy pointed out, Lalit Modi was in charge back then. Probably chose to handle the situation a little differently, of course. Watching Srishant in tears on television might have swayed the jury back then. Mark, in international cricket, you obviously don't have franchise owners or board officials going in and having discussion with a match referee when these decisions are made. How differently would this have played out if this was international cricket?
I don't know, to be honest with you. Very difficult to tell. The one thing I do know about these incidences is that whilst they're not good for the game in terms of its spirit, they do bring a certain sort of, even if it's unwanted, sort of attention and glamour to the game, right? And I'm not condoning them in any way, but I think that you get high-profile players going at each other. It's well known that West Indies and Australian cricket are going at each other all of the time at the moment. There's real sort of simmering hatred between the two countries for some reason. I don't know what that is. It's probably got something to do with David Warner, but never mind. and when these things spill over, okay, it doesn't look good. But it does sort of again ramp up the sort of the interest in cricket, which is why it is so important that the punishments absolutely crack down on it. You say to them, listen, it's fine. You do what you want. Throw your gloves off and have a roll around in the middle of the pitch if you like. But if you do that, you're going to get banned for three games. Yeah. And then it's dealt with, isn't it? You need to deal with it properly once it happens and then move on. Hope it doesn't happen again, but when it does happen again, the fine is there and you have to hit people hard with them.
Well, the verdict then is that it was an opportunity lost for the IPL, and mine goes back to the initial reaction from the commentators on air. They said, this makes for good television. We spoke about this yesterday. Does this really make for good television is the question that the IPL needs to ask itself, and the answer probably would be staring them in the face. So that was the talking point today.